Hello everybody, I'm Ramesh Bhatlish from Fidji Noida. Generally, students have the apprehension, you know, that when you're preparing for JEE, you neglect the board exams. But then there's a methodology by which you can perform well in both the exams. While you're preparing for your board exams, you should take up the topics in the similar flow as it is there in the JEE main. So when you're taking up a topic, you ensure that you do questions which are in the board as well as in the JEE main. When solving them in boards, you will ensure that you will mention all the elaborate steps which you would have overlooked or skipped when solving JEE main level questions. In JEE main, you need to develop shortcuts for solving all those questions. But in board exams, you need to write down all the essential steps so that you can also gain from step marking. Here, there are certain topics in each subject, physics, chemistry, and mathematics, which are there both in JEE main as well as in the board exams. For example, in physics, if I talk about semiconducting devices, you can say communication techniques, these are there both in JEE main as well as board exams. So students, when they are picking up these topics, they must solve it in an elaborate manner so that they are able to get good marks in their boards. One more important thing is, when you are taking the board exam paper, try to solve questions in a descriptive manner. Mention all the essential steps. Your handwriting should be good. You should avoid, you know, using any kind of shortcuts when picking up the numericals of board exams. And you should do neat work, because when your copies are checked, the examiner is more careful about how you have presented your answers. So it is important that you go through previous year's board papers and get to know the kind of questions they have been asked, and also see previous board solutions of some of the toppers, so that you get to know what are the important things which must be mentioned when you're attempting the board exam paper. Now, when you're solving the JEE main exams, definitely you should have practiced a lot of objective type questions, because the JEE main exam is an objective paper. Unlike the you can say the board exam, which is strictly subjective, you will have to take several mock tests before the JEE main exam. Get to know your time management, how you to attempt which kind of questions, which questions you need to leave, which questions you need to solve. You have to maintain a sense of, you know, calm and cool behavior while the 3 hours of the paper. Reason being, you have to be very clear how much you need to score. And you can't keep on thinking about a particular question in case you are unable to solve. So here you have to adopt a leave and move forward strategy in case you are unable to solve a particular question. So in JEE main, I'll advise that you take the paper in two rounds and ensure that in each round you solve a number of, you can say a couple of questions, which you are solving them correctly and don't lose any mark. And at the same time, ensure that you get to you get another round so that you can solve some questions of the subject which you found easier in the first round. So here you can maximize your score both in all the three subjects as well as your aggregate. So that's it for how you can balance your JEE main with boards and also perform optimally in the JEE main exam.
Like the video, subscribe to our YouTube channel and stay updated on other universities and entrance exams. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and www.careers360.com.